Hello everyone. In this video, I will guide you on how to use the Exness trade application. This is an application that helps you manage your client area on the Exness platform. This management operation will be performed on your phone. With this application, you can deposit money, withdraw money, manage accounts, or directly conduct transactions on it. It is very convenient, helping you to earn money anytime, anywhere. This is the Exness Market Channel, where we provide the most useful information about trading activities on the Exness platform. We are a leading development partner of Exness. If you're new to Exness Market, make sure to hit the subscribe button to stay updated with our latest videos. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below, and our team will get back to you as soon as possible. You'll find the registration guide and the latest Exness updates in the video description and pinned comment. Besides this channel, you can also visit our Exness Market website to explore more about Exness. To use the Exness Trade app, you first need to download and install the application on your phone. Then go to the App Store. For phones using the iOS operating system, it's on App Store. Alright, in the search section, I will type Exness. The Exness Trade application should appear at the top of the search results like this. Then we click on Install. After the application has been downloaded and installed, I will open the app. When the app first launches, it will display a section like this. Here, if you do not have an account on the Exness platform, you can click Register to create an account. If you do not know how to open and verify an account, you can follow the video tutorial on opening and verifying an account that I have left in the pinned comment section or in the description of the video. Here, I assume that you already have an account, so I will click Sign In to log into the account. In this login section, please enter your email address and password, then click Sign In. It will then take you to the Set Passcode section like this. This passcode is a quick login code that helps you log in faster in subsequent logins to the application. In subsequent logins, you will only need to enter this passcode without having to enter your email address and account password, which will be much faster. After setting the passcode, we will be able to log in to the application like this. When you first log in, it will be in the first tab, the Account tab, looking at the bottom of the screen. This application will have five main tabs: Account, Trade, Market, Performance, and Profile. First is the Account tab. This tab will contain information about our accounts. For example, whether this account belongs to MetaTrader 4 or MetaTrader 5. What type of account it is, the account number, which is the account ID, and the amount of money in the account. In the Open, Pending, and close sections below, this is where information about ongoing transactions is displayed. The open section shows currently open trading orders. The pending section shows pending orders. The close section shows closed orders. Above the account name, you will see a downward arrow. You can click on it. When you click on that arrow, it will show a list of real accounts as well as demo accounts. Currently, it is in the real account section. You can see that I have quite a few real accounts like this. And next to it is a list of demo accounts. These are the currently available accounts. You can also open more real or demo accounts to conduct transactions. To open more accounts, you will click on the plus sign in the upper right corner. If you want to create a new demo account, you will select demo account. If you want to create a new real account, you will select real account. The process for opening these accounts is similar. For example, here, I will choose a demo account. I will select demo account. To choose the account type, you can hold on the screen and drag to the left. Here you can see that it will provide us with different account types: Standard Account, Pro Account, Zero Account, and Raw Spread Account. Basic information about these accounts is written right below. For example, here I want to open a Raw Spread account, so I will select Raw Spread and click Continue at the bottom. The next step, I will choose the currency to be displayed in the account. Usually, we will leave it as USD. If you want to choose a different currency, you will click on the USD. As you can see, there are many different currencies, but commonly we just use USD. Next is the leverage section. This leverage section is the account's leverage, depending on the type of account you open. For example, with a raw spread account, I can use unlimited leverage, or I can choose a specific leverage. For example, 1 to 500. After choosing the leverage, I will name the account in the account nickname section below. I will click on it and name the account. You can skip this part. It will automatically assign a name for us. After naming it, I will click continue. The next step is to set a password for this account. For the account password, you need to note that it must be 8 to 15 characters long, contain a combination of letters and numbers, and include both uppercase and lowercase letters. So, you set a password that meets these conditions. After setting the password, you click OK. That's it. We have completed creating a new account. You can see that with the actions I just performed. It shows here as a MetaTrader 5 account. To open a MetaTrader 4 account, we will also do it similarly. I will click on the arrow next to the account name. I will click on the plus sign. Then I will click on Demo Account. To select a MetaTrader 4 account, in the upper right corner, there is a gear icon. You will click on it and select MetaTrader 4 account. Then click Confirm. Next, you proceed with similar steps as opening a MetaTrader 5 account. With a real account or a demo account, you can perform deposit or withdraw, meaning you can deposit money into the account or withdraw money from that account. To deposit money into the account, you will click Deposit. You enter the amount of money you want to deposit into the account. For example, here I click on the number 200. Then I click Continue. So, here I have deposited $200 into the account. This is a demo account, so the deposit operation is simple like that. However, with a real account, here I will select a real account. For example, with this raw spread account, when we click Deposit, it will lead us to the Deposit Methods section. And here, you will need to choose the payment method. You can use internet banking, Neteller e-wallet, bank card, or other e-wallets, and so on. There are many different methods. In Vietnam, we commonly use internet banking services. Next, in the To Account section, you will select the account you want to deposit money into. The Amount section below is where you enter the amount you want to deposit. And please note that the amount of money we deposit for the first deposit will have certain regulations. For example, with raw spread accounts, pro accounts, or zero spread accounts, for the first deposit to that account, the minimum required deposit amount is $200. You cannot deposit less than that. Therefore, if you trade on these account types, raw spread account, zero account, or pro account, you can deposit an amount greater than $200. Then withdraw a portion of the money, leaving a small amount for trading. For new traders, we can trade on small accounts in this way. Then, we proceed to click continue and complete the deposit steps. The deposit procedure is also very simple. You just click continue and it will guide you very specifically. In case you want to withdraw money, you click withdraw. If you want to transfer money to another account or perform other operations, you click on the three dots next to withdraw. Here it will have the transfer section, where you can transfer money to another account or transfer money back and forth between your MetaTrader 4 and MetaTrader 5 accounts. Or you can view the transaction history and perform settings. That's the information for the first tab. The second tab is the trade tab. When we first enter this trade tab, it helps us see the products we are tracking. The favorite section is a list of products that we have added to our favorites. For frequent monitoring, the popular section lists popular products. Other rankings are placed later. We usually focus on the favorite section. We can add more products to this favorite section or remove some products from this favorite section to have a concise list that makes it easier for us to find the products we are interested in. In this section, at the very top, you can also see the account that this trading section refers to. What does that mean? For example, here I have a MetaTrader 4 account, right? With the suffix 216. So, when I leave it like this and in the favorite section below, I see a product I am interested in. I want to trade that product on the account currently displayed here, which is account 216. Then I will click on the product I want to trade. For example, here is the gold USD product. And with this product, I can proceed to click buy or sell. However, there is a note here, which is that trading directly on this Exness trade application only supports MetaTrader 5 accounts. As for MetaTrader 4 accounts, at the current stage, at the time I am making this video, it is not yet supported. It is possible that future updates will support MetaTrader 4 accounts as well. However, currently it only supports MetaTrader 5 accounts. Therefore, to trade on account 216, we will need to continue the login process to the MetaTrader 4 platform before we can start trading. As for here, I will give you an example. which is that I will choose a MetaTrader 5 account and I will choose a demo account to trade for you to see. When we are in the chart section like this, and we want to go back to the list of products we are interested in, you can click on the back arrow at the very bottom, or you can pull down this chart section by swiping down from the product name. That way, we will return to the list of products we are interested in. So, once we are in this list, we will select the account at the very top. I will click on it. I will choose this demo account. I will choose a MetaTrader 5 account to try trading. A demo MetaTrader 5 account with the suffix 473. Now I will go back to the gold USD product here. At the very bottom, there you go. To proceed with trading this gold USD product, I will do as follows. You can see that with the current market trend, I predict that it may continue to go down. So I will click on this sell button. After clicking sell, I will set the trading volume. You can click the plus or minus signs next to the trading volume. The unit of this trading volume is lot. Then, after setting the trading volume, we can go down to the settings section below. You can edit in the order setting section. You click on that order setting section. Currently, it is in the market order section, meaning trading at the current market price. You can also switch to sell limit to set pending sell limit orders, or switch to sell stop. Since we clicked sell earlier, here it only displays sell limit or sell stop. However, if we clicked buy, then in this section it would display buy limit and buy stop. For example, here I will leave it as market order. After I have selected the order type, I will click confirm sell. There, you see, I have executed a 0.04 lot trade, and that order is displayed in the upper section, right below the name of the trading product. For this chart section, you can zoom in and out by placing two fingers on the screen and pinching in or out to zoom the screen in or out. You can go to the overview section to see the fluctuations of this product within 1 hour, or within a day, week, month, or year, or you can scroll down to see some additional information, some news related to the product we are trading, or you can go to the specification section to see information about our orders. Pay attention to the symbols to the right of the product name. The first symbol is a star. Currently, the star is displayed in black, meaning this product is in the favored section. If you click on that star, the star will turn white, meaning this product has been removed from the favored list, which means we are no longer tracking this product. Here, I want to keep this product, so I will click on the star again to move it back to the favored section. Next is the briefcase icon. You click on it. What it actually does is it displays information about the products we are currently trading, the orders we are currently executing. The open section shows one, meaning there is one active trade, and this order is currently losing $1.19. The pending section has no orders. The close section shows the orders we closed previously. That's for the briefcase icon. As for the bell icon, that's where we set price alerts. You can set price alerts so that when the price reaches a certain level, it will notify you, and then you can return to the chart to monitor whether the market at that time has enough factors for you to execute trading orders. This alert is also very useful. You can learn how to use this section most effectively. The next symbol is the calendar icon. You click on it. What it actually does is it displays information related to the product we are trading here. For example, the spread of this product, pip value, which is the minimum pip, and the swap fees of this product. Some other information, you can find out more in this section. To view information about ongoing trades, you can also return to the first tab. This first tab will also contain information about ongoing trades. When you want to stop the trade you just made, you can go to the account section. You click on the trade you want to adjust. You can click view chart to see the chart and decide whether to close this trade or not. Or you can click close order to close this trade immediately. You can also set take profit or stop loss in this section. Here I will close this order immediately. Close order. I click confirm. I close this order. We move to the third tab. The third tab, the market tab, will contain information about news or analyses related to the products we are interested in. Here, in the upcoming events section, it will show us the news that is about to happen. You can also click show more to learn more. In general, this section provides us with additional information to support us in market analysis. Here, it also has analysis articles on trading signals. The trading signals section, you can click here. You can click show more to find out more about signal analysis articles. The fourth tab is the performance tab. This performance tab summarizes our trading performance during the past period. For example, here, the performance section is set to on real account, meaning I am displaying all information related to real accounts. And last 7 days means the display time is over the past 7 days. This is a new account, so I haven't traded anything in the real account, so nothing is displayed here. You click on real account. Then you can find information about each specific account, to see how the trading activity is for that account. This section only shows information related to real accounts. Demo accounts are not displayed in this performance section. Then, the fifth tab is the profile tab. This profile tab displays our account information. In this profile section, you can perform live chat, meaning chat directly with customer support to get your questions answered faster. You can also click log out to log out of this account. To perform some other settings, you can click on the gear icon in the upper right corner. When you enter that gear section, it will go to the settings section. And here, you can perform some other settings related to the account or display here. For example, you can select language to choose the display language. When you select language, you can also choose the Vietnamese interface. When you switch to Vietnamese, all the displays here have changed to Vietnamese, not English anymore. In the settings section, you can also set the security type, or change the passcode, enable fingerprint login, or choose whether to allow screen recording or screen capture. You click here to turn it on or off. That's all the information related to this Exness trade application. I would like to end the video tutorial on using the application here. Thank you for watching the video. If you find the video useful, please remember to give the video a like and click the subscribe button. Click the bell icon next to it to receive the latest videos when the channel releases them. Thank you, and see you in the next videos.